Yo, 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 yo.
How's everybody doing?
No, I wish.
Wait, will you sing? Will you sing this lullaby for us?
I don't know this song.
Just make up some words.
Oh, yeah.
That's good. You can turn on the echo. That always works, too.
Oh, sure. Happy Tuesday, everybody.
Tuesday. Do I hear Michaela Television?
It's really funny. I didn't even let anybody know in my Twitch
that you were gonna be here.
I wasn't even doing my thing in lieu of this. So I just forgot. I was so busy, and then I'm like, I gotta write these songs, and so he's like,
I definitely walked in. For the record, I'm gonna steal your bit. There's definitely 30 songs printed out here. Did you email them over to Bryce to print out?
Yes, I printed them. I was like, I don't have a printer. I'm like, what am I gonna do? These were literally the fastest. This is the fastest shit I've ever come up with in my entire life.
What are these acceptance speeches? And I'm like, oh, these are songs. These are chords. Mm-hmm. Oh my god.
By the way, Mike, I forwarded to you the order, the random orders
for the show. Okay. Awesome. Perfect. Thank you.
That's in your email.
That's one thing that I never got. I was always scrambling. I'm like, what's the one next? That's
perfect. Justin and I.
T2T2.
This is your phone. Sorry. I thought it was my phone.
And T2T2.
Where is my phone?
I don't know where your phone is.
Oh, I plugged it in right over there. Very delicious. I like the part where I just stole your phone. I was like, thank you for the phone. You know what it is? Is because you do the same thing I do. You always leave your earbuds tethered.
Because I lose them all the time, and it drives me insane.
Yeah.
So whenever I'm using them, then they're always attached to my phone.
Yeah.
Because that way I don't have to spend Lenina!
Justin and I definitely spent 90 minutes in a pre-show team meeting. We went over what our expected values were for each of the different movies.
Yes, awesome.
We also went over like general strategy. We're all I don't want to share our super secret inside sauce, but it's like, okay, people tend to overvalue these. They tend to undervalue these. The big mistake is blank. And it's like, we don't know what's going to come in what order. If this comes earlier, then jump on it. If it comes later, don't jump on it.
And it's crazy because there are what appears to be a lot of stinkers that still might do gigantic dollars. That's so crazy. I'm like, how can it be? Like, there's some things, there's a handful I'm not going to mention, but then I'm like, this is potentially got, I don't know if it's got legs, but it's potentially like a gigantic opening.
Yeah.
And I'm like, and it's obvious that it's piffle. It's obvious that I'm like that's so crazy.
What's funny is there's the one layer of like the mere fact of trying to guess what everything's going to end up as. That's Hollywood's full-time job.
Yeah.
But on top of that, not only do you have to be able to guess what stuff's going to do, give or take, but you also have to play the other players. And these are the biases that people are going to fall for.
Yeah. And are we going to drive? Can we drive him up and get him to pay max dollar?
Right.
And there's
certain properties that it's like, well, everybody loves this movie. They love it too much. It's too close. It's too precious.
Yeah.
Avoid it because it's everyone's going to love it.
Yeah.
It's, yeah.
You know what? Another. I'm not sure if there's another metric you've been tracking, but you might want to check into it. Is just views on trailers. Like because there are certain trailers I'm like this is gonna be terrible and it has 30 million views.
Well, and
I'm like oh my god, there's a ton of interest in this movie.
This is
so even if a small percentage of the people that checked it out go to it, it's still gonna do better than this movie, which I thought was gonna be amazing, but only had like 300,000 views.
I'm gonna pull back the kimono a little bit and reveal some of my strategy. Is oftentimes the some of the best plays I've made have been where I bought something based on the fundamentals, like it's got this guy, this director, this actor, and this studio behind it.
Yeah.
And yes, none of us have seen any trailers about it.
Yeah.
But it like Logan was one of those where it was like the fundamentals were too strong.
Even though we
hadn't seen anything from it.
Yeah.
So I was able to buy it low to bet on it,
which is so crazy because I knew that it was obvious. The thing is, like, if you're a Marvel fan, you finally get to see a Wolverine. I'm the best at what I do, bub, and what I do is not very nice. He says that in every fucking comic.
Yeah,
and this is the first time you get to see him do what he does best.
How good was that movie?
Oh my god, it was awesome.
Did you cry?
Yeah, I mean, I read the comic, so I kind of knew what was coming out.
Sure.
The thing
is,
but I definitely choked up at lots of the character moments.
Okay, I watched it twice.
The little girl rocked my world.
Like, she was amazing. The actress was amazing.
Yes.
I watched it twice. The first time I was just a blubbering mess the entire time long.
Yeah.
The second time I was like, there's no way I'm going to cry. Because I've already seen it. And then the first three times I cried, I was like, well, let's start counting. Seven goddamn times. It's
That's awesome. This was awesome. Watching what?
A trailer for pancake batter.
Does anybody know what Captain Underpants is?
It's a kid's book. It's a kid's book.
I know that, but the thing is like, but there's nothing. The only trailer they have is which I think is a brilliant trailer. It's a joke trailer. It's a joke trailer, right?
I mean,
that's all there is. It's funny. It's the only thing I've ever seen that has like thousands more dislikes than likes. You know, for something that's upcoming. I'm like,
yeah,
that's so
yeah.
crazy.
I mean, but who's like, hey, fuck Captain Underpants? Like who has that kind of conviction in their life that they're like, hey, innocuous kids movie, eat shit. I had higher standards than this. Captain Underpants bullshit.
Yeah, and the thing is, and there's nothing, and there's not even anything there. It's literally just a text-based trailer where they're talking about. It's amazing. If you haven't checked it out, you should. It's amazing because what they're doing is they're like, okay, the trailer for this thing is just about to come out, but let's talk about what you expect in a trailer. And so it's kind of like focus group testing of the audience, like what kind of music, what song do you think would be a great song for the trailer?
So
it's fucking genius. And the thing is like, and people are just livid. They're
it. It's them trolling
yes,
the audience.
It's them trolling
oh,
the
that's
audience,
great.
And they're just flaming, and the audience is just flaming. And I'm like, you guys are fucking getting trolled, and you don't even see it.
Oh,
it's fucking
great.
Genius. I fucking loved it. I'm like, so,
I mean, I guess if you're a kid's movie, it's like, I don't know, whatever. We're not going to play this shit on Nickelodeon. So, like, you know, put whatever on YouTube. Yeah, put the fuck you. It's just like, hey, fuck you, YouTube. You're fucking assholes. All of you watching this. Fuck you. Go see Captain Underpants. Like, who cares? You have no reason. Like, you know, it's just you're going to be there. What matters is how much you put, you know, your commercials between the micro
machines. Oh, God damn it.
Yeah. You, yeah. And
I just realized the Fate of the Furious is the eighth Furious movie,
yes.
And Fate
yes.
is a play on that. God
yes.
damn it!
Oh,
eight.
Brian.
God damn it!
Oh, Brian.
Yeah, fuck.
Brian,
fuck.
This is why they came this close to making it F8T.
Okay. All right.
Okay.
Right.
F8T.
F8TE.
We're.
This is why we're a team, Justin. We complete each other.
Bryce, where did you send that?
I'm going to let everyone know.
Oh, okay. All right.
Is there a better one? I can...
No. Oh, there we go. I just got it. Thank
okay.
you. Perfect. Awesome. Thank you.
Cool, yeah. Keep that a secret.
Yeah,
dude. That's valuable intel.
No. Oh, okay. Oh, my God. Really? Oh, wait. No. This is good.
What do you mean, really? Wait. What is this? I'm judging... I
have a handful of songs that reference other songs, right? So things like... So I have a song... I have two or three songs
songs. Here's my trick.
And
I'm starting when you finish those songs, say like, that was foreshadowing.
That's all you have to say.
Exactly, and then we'll know.
That's exactly what the first one's going to have to be.
Brian Brushwood, everybody.
Yeah. Excuse me while I take a moment to explain how to do music to my TV.
Hey, Brian, can you and Justin talk? I'm going to swap mics with Mike.
We're not very good at talking. Justin, are you any good at talking?
We've actually made a conscious decision to not talk anymore.
Well, and specifically to each other, right? Like, I mean, that's
oh,
the weird
yeah.
part.
Oh, no, totally like, to each other.
We're allowed to
other
talk.
People all the time.
Like, I'm sorry, Bryce, we didn't explain. Like, I'll be asking you repeatedly to, like, will you please tell Justin that I don't agree with that price? And then I'll need you to relay that to him because we're not speaking.
Waited for somebody to basically become the producer just so we could no longer speak to each other.
Yeah. Also, you know what? We're going to just stare intently at each other. And if you could, like, the whole show is just going to be a series of the phrase, what I'd imagine Brian is thinking is, and then just run with it.
And like, just, yes.
I would imagine Justin is going to respond
thinking,
with,
fuck you, Captain Underpants.
So this first song is gonna make no sense, and then but then later on, oh, it makes perfect sense, and it's hilarious, hilarious.
Also, you can plug in with that quarter.
Mm, mm.
Yes. Shit, we gotta start blowing this up, man. This is a big night. This is one of the biggest nights That's of the year.
Hey, there I am. It is a big night.
All right. Do I sound sexy?
Do I sound more like myself?
Do I sound more like myself? Ooh. Like this is my natural.
Also, Brian, we can talk about what we're doing next week, right? Because we do have to mention the show might be a little.
Oh yes. By the way, I unrepentantly canceled a college show. That is something I never do. Never, ever do. I'm always sad. I'm always like, hey, man, I always try to figure out how to make it work. But this time, I just wrote an email. They're like, I will not be doing your gig because this is happening. And then the response was, holy shit, that's awesome. Do you know anyone who could do the gig?
Oh, cool. Yeah, cool. Right on. Yeah.
Because you're dealing with college guys,
weren't you? And they're like, this is amazing.
Yeah. Like, look, man, they could smell cool a mile away. And they knew that I was touching it, if not made of it myself. Pete Bois ended up getting the gig. Nice. And Pete was like, do you want a commission? And I was like, nope, your service is all I require. Thank you.
Goodbye. Yeah. Also, fuck Captain Underpants.
But there's a good chance that when you guys do the show next week, you will all be in the same place, potentially.
Possibly. Likely we'll be in the same place. The question is, what day we do it?
Is this code? Are you guys speaking code right now? You're speaking code.
I mean, like this deal this came together on the street.
People have tweeted so about it to you guys publicly.
Like, yeah, no, that's fine. But I want to save it for the show. Like, we'll
it doesn't have like. Part of me is like, this show.
Oh, this show is gonna be all the movie all draft. Yeah. Okay. All right. We'll tell everyone.
You should tell people now because we're gonna send people during the draft to the pre-show and the after-show for the funny stuff.
That's a good point. Hey, guess which two podcast hosts are gonna be in a movie?
What
movie?
Guy from Serial?
They're going to Hollywood.
The two guys from
we're gonna. Justin and I. This is a real thing that's happening. Justin and I are gonna hop on planes. We're gonna fly to L.A. to Hollywood. We're going to appear in Romany Malco's Prison Logic movie.
Awesome.
We're going to play the role like it's a faux documentary. So in some respect,
we don't know, right? Because didn't he say that our roles have shifted?
Oh, he did. Last I heard, you're robots.
We do not know. All we know is that we don't know what our roles are. The last we had heard, we were the documentarians. But I think we heard that on stream. I think he said that on stream.
That's why I didn't hesitate to mention it. But like last we heard, and we know it's something different now, whatever it is.
Yeah.
But last we heard, we were going to be the cameramen who were so it's like theoretically we are there the entire time.
Oh yeah.
But just not on screen, right? But yeah.
But whatever they if they do anything with camera moves and stuff like that, that's ostensibly you.
Yeah, theoretically, hypothetically,
it would be. So we would. I guess we get a couple scenes or something. But yeah, I guess they don't need us for long. But we're going there Monday and Tuesday next week. So
dude, awesome. it's crazy to get somebody like so me canceling a college show, and again, like 20 years, man, that just does not happen.
Yeah,
but
yeah.
It's like I'm very sorry. I've been invited to Hollywood to be in a movie, and then just no resistance. They were it's great. Who do you recommend? Cool story, bro.
Yeah, that's it's funny. It's old goes to Hollywood.
It's funny
cancellation.
That excuse always works. Like occasionally when I need to skip
you'll
work,
say, I'm gonna I'm be
like,
in
yeah,
a movie.
I was invited to be in a movie, and they're always like, okay, Mike, you go.
Yeah,
do your thing, man. Yeah. That's like you can pretty much use that for anything. Like, oh yeah. I'm sorry, I need to go to jail, I get it, but I've got to be in a movie.
Ren Aigu says, that's very gracious of Rami Malek.
No. All right.
Hey, guys, no, it's not that.
No.
It's your old buddy, Romany Malco.
No, Tijuana Jackson is his name.
Well, Tijuana, that's the character. I'll tell you, no, Romany Malco was the one crying big girl tears on this this year program when this movie got funded.
Yeah, man. That was great. That's great. Also, while I am out there, That's the other thing is that there's a thing in May that Greg Grunberg is doing a charity stream for and asked me to work and was asking if I would shoot some stuff. So that I was thinking, I called Tom today to see if I could crash at his place because mm-hmm. I was just going to come out for that batch of days and plan on doing both of those. You know, all those Hollywood
All those things. Hollywood commitments. All
the Hollywood commitments.
Yeah, no, I'll tell you what. I wish I could spend the week in L.A., but I got to go to WrestleMania.
Ugh.
My flight to WrestleMania is Wednesday.
Oh, man.
Which Wednesday? Like the before or after Wednesday? Like tomorrow Wednesday or a week
no,
from now?
No, like the reason why we have to move the show next week.
Yeah.
Because they asked us to do Monday and Tuesday, understanding that we would only do either Monday or Tuesday.
But to keep them both free.
But right. To keep them both free, right?
Yeah.
So since I have a flight out of SFO at
what are you
Wednesday,
at?
Or on Wednesday morning, I got to be back in San Francisco Tuesday night. So we'll either have to do the show Monday night at a semi-normal time or Tuesday in the afternoon. And it might even just be one of those we just recorded locally or live stream it off my laptop or whatever kind of deals.
Because there's also – because Monday is also pushing around Cord Killers and Weird Things.
We can also maybe –
Well, Weird Things, yeah. I figure Weird Things – we're going to figure out something to do with Weird Things because we're all going to be in L.A. So.
Sure, but I'm just saying.
Is it
– What's up?
Sorry, I'm trying to figure out when are they – reusing that first stage. I think they're announcing it, SpaceX is, in the next week.
I don't remember.
Yeah, no, I think it's next month that they're doing it. I think they've already announced the date, haven't they?
Hey, everybody, I just wanted to do a really quick segment, if I could.
What?
Oh, sure, yeah, man, go
Social
ahead.
Social eating. I got a package the other day here at the...
Oh, you've got a package already.
Hey. From Brian, who I believe is BK offered in the chat, Brian, sent along a snack that I had never seen before, but it makes sense. It's not crazy. I just had never considered it. It is, let me pull up the thing here. Haribo ginger lemon gummy candy. You guys seen this? You heard about this?
Yeah. That sounds delicious. I like ginger and lemon, and I believe I've had ginger lemon things before.
That's
how the ethnics talk.
Right. You're about to be a movie star, Brian. You can't keep talking about it.
You're about to be a movie star, don't you? Hey, this is what torpedoes our chances.
Listen, man, everything was cool until the Haribo segment.
I'm scared of it.
Come on, Bri. Just get a little taste in your sweet little mouth.
You've said that before.
Nice. Oh, so, okay.
Yeah, it definitely has a ginger lemony smell, which you kind of don't always expect from a dry gummy candy like this. Oh, Brian, you're making the most interesting face right now.
I'm making the one face I make.
He's trying not to call it delightful. He's not trying to call it delightful.
It's the most, but it's the most, but also the least interesting face. equally.
Brant definitely called me out that every reaction to Brian tasting everything looks the same.
A lot of lemon, not a lot of ginger.
Yeah, but there's
but it's just the right amount of
a little
bite.
Touch of ginger.
Yeah.
Well, but let's come on. Let's be honest. In that tag team, someone's carrying most of the weight, and it's the lemon. It's the lemon deserves the headlining spot.
I mean, it doesn't even get top billing. It's ginger lemon.
That's it's way good.
It's humble.
I don't like any of the Haribo gummy bears.
You hate sweet stuff.
Well, yes. Except when there's a bite. Like I do like orange slices, right? Specifically,
you don't like lemon. Do you like lemon?
I do. Citrus is the only member of the fruit family that I like because, again, it's oftentimes it's bitter and has some bite.
So
do you
dig this? Like, would you get
love
this?
Yeah. I love it. I love it.
That's
great.
Yeah.
Well, in fact, it's funny because I ate two back to back. Like, just
what's funny is when you chew it, it's the experience of lemon. But when it's over with,
it's ginger. Very
ginger. Yeah. It's also a little spicy.
You just ate ginger.
Thank you so much, Brian, for sending this in. not you, Brian. The other Brian.
Yeah, well, no, you could thank me. I ate it. It's on a dare.
Thank you for giving us a place to eat that. Eat those.
All right. Do we have any news bloopers?
We do.
Can we play our game?
Yes.
By the way, thank you to everybody who's currently listening right now, because that means you're one of two things. You're either a person who's tuned in live, in which case you're the best of humanity, or you're somebody who is a patron and listening on your own private RSS feed. They're lesser people. They're lesser.
No,
I mean, if we could get 10,000 people showing up live, that would be the best.
We're gonna have one time to do one of these. Okay.
Okay. Right.
We don't have. We have to get everybody on the phone. Oh, great. Here we go. Let's see here.
Dude, that shot song that by the Possum Posse, like, do they have any recorded version? Like, you said that was the first time they'd ever done that tour de force version of going through, like,
six. They did an album, Rap Attack.
Well, they did. They did, but it was always like it was a one-note joke, and instead it became something bigger.
Let's see. I think we can just hear one.
All right.
We've got Fox 28 News.
Good evening, I'm
Tracy.
All right.
Okay.
Good evening, I'm Tracy something.
The headline is can't hear shit. I'm going to guess this guy's monitor is not working, his IFB.
Okay. I'm going to guess that he doesn't think that they're actually starting and is incredulous.
Oh, you think it's practice? You think he thinks that it's not showtime?
He just thinks that they're calling for live because they're fucking idiots, and he's just like, well, I can't hear shit. Like,
all right. This is a new level of the game. Like, you got to the point where you're doing an impression of how you imagine it's going to go.
This is what I think.
All right. In which case,
I'm gonna say he's gonna look both ways twice.
Okay. And you know what? I'm gonna say he's gonna be like, it'll be right away. It'll be like the music plays, and he immediately goes, I can't hear shit. I don't understand. Is this? And he looks to her to see if she's able to hear shit. But neither of them can hear shit because shit doesn't make noise.
All right, here we go.
And I'm Rick Schutz. Breaking news out of Elkhart. Elkhart Police confirmed to Fox 28 tonight that Kimberly Walker and her four children have been found and are safe.
Well, they also tell us that the suspect in question, 30-year-old Jerry White, is in custody. They were found tonight at the Sleepy Hollow Motel on Cassopolis Street in Elkhart. On Fox 28's Melanie Morales.
Oh, it's a remote.
It's a remote. It's a remote. We got
live
it.
Remote fail.
Now, obviously satisfying end to this man hurt tonight.
I can't hear shit.
We apologize for the
Melanie! Melanie! Come on!
Oh no.
It's pretty good.
And
pretty
then they cut back to her for one frame and she's totally out of the picture. That's great.
Yeah.
All right. Give me a few minutes, guys.
By the way, I love the fact that, like, I watched one of those of these MIDI music pictures, and now that's all my feed is filled with on the recommended. Like girl there.
Oh yeah.
Here, just click play on that thing.
Okay.
Yeah.
So they make pictures using.
That's kind of awesome. Oh, I think what they did is they put it in time. It's still awesome.
Yeah.
What the hell is that?
I think it's the word Rachel.
Happy birthday, Bach. Yeah.
Happy birthday, Bach.
Maybe that was a image of Bach. Rach, maybe? Rachel? That was it.
No, that's Bach.
No, it's Bach.
No. There's no way that guy was Bach. That's a little girl.
All right, guys.
Well, it says Tabak and Dad.
Tabak and Dad. Okay, yeah, I mean, that's
the title of the
Max
video.
Max Robot to Iraq?
Yeah. to Iraq?
Wow. I mean, I know.
Heroin
is everywhere.
Herring? Hairline?
Heroin?
Heroin?
Hey, Justin, I have to hang up on you and add you to a group call. Okay?
Yeah, bye, Justin.
Oh, God.
Finally got rid of that excess baggage. Hello, C. Robert Cargill. How are you?
Hi, everybody.
Man, are you ready to be as historically good at this game as you've always been?
I am ready to be better. I have some resources this time. But I am prepared for the ultimate loss.
Right on. How are you, Milongo?
I'm good. How are you guys doing?
Good, good, good. Is that a tablet PC? What are you rocking there?
Oh, this is a crazy Wacom.
Wacom.
I can draw on it and crazy stuff.
Right on. So
part of my day job.
Did you get that from Aliens?
That's just a tutorial that I'm watching. But I could say I got that from Aliens. Good. That sounds better.
I say, well, like Mexican immigrants, something like that.
So Cargill, are you repping solo or do you have a team?
I have a team.
What? Okay.
I have a teammate. All right. I have a member.
Right on.
Wow.
I have a buddy.
Good deal. All right. So we're getting Justin and Tom back on.
That's right. Hey, Juice.
Where is my teammate? Nope.
Yeah, she didn't answer. Let me see if I can add her back. Hi, Tom.
Hello, gentlemen.
Hey, man. Congratulations on the launch of Pilot X. I'm so super stoked. I bought it on Audible today.
Hey, awesome.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, the narrator's awesome. He did a great job. And it's not me, in case anyone thinks.
I bought both your book and Andrew's book today.
Hi, Christy.
On Audible.
Nice.
Hi.
Hello, Christy.
Hello.
Hey.
Christy Gates.
Are you guys ready to dominate as our sponsored team? Cord Killers presents yes. Christy Gates and Milongo.
I can't wait for us to win, Brian.
See, that's the way you win one of these games is number one, you invent all the rules. Number two, you sponsor all the teams. So no matter who wins, you're the winner. Yay.
You know what, Brian? We should buy them like Little League jerseys that say Cord Killers on the back.
Oh, yeah, do it.
That would actually be great.
That'd be cool.
Our only goal this time is to make sure we spend all of our money.
Hey, that's a good goal.
Mom keeps yelling at me for that, so that's my goal this time as well.
My goal is to come in the middle of the pack.
Yeah, it's to not be dead last. It's to not go on record as saying Green Lantern will be the biggest movie of the summer.
Oh, no.
I knew you were going to bring that up.
You know what? You know what?
Good things early on, Chris, insider things, and they were wrong.
Chris, there are certain universes where it was the biggest movie of the year. So things like he just happened to be in the wrong universe. Sorry, man. It sucks.
Look, all I'm gonna say is I have such foresight. I knew that Ryan Reynolds was gonna make one of the biggest superhero movies of all time.
Yes.
The timing was a bit off.
You're like, this guy's a star. He's a star, I tell you.
Hi, Jenny.
The crisis in infinite box offices.
He's pulling the John Edward. He's just like, he's famous for a comic book movie. It's the biggest comic book movie of all time. There's an iconic color he wears.
All right. Who are we? Oh, we're waiting on Father Robert.
Father Robert.
Who might have friend of the community. Wait.
We have an extraordinarily unprepared Jenny.
Hey, Jenny!
Yay! Don't worry, I'm not so unprepared.
Are we live in the chat room and all that kind of fun stuff now?
Chat room's on fire right now.
That's an extraordinarily unprepared Jenny is a great sobriquet.
If you guys haven't already seen, I emailed you instructions on how to get into DraftRaptor, our drafting software.
DraftRaptor.
So you may want to check the emails that I contacted you guys on for your authorization key. That's the word.
Hey, I'm accidentally in there twice somehow, so if someone wants to repair that, that would be cool. I don't know what I did.
You're just really excited.
How many Christies do you need on your team Cord Killers?
Yeah.
Okay.
There are like four Christies on Team Cord Killers in Draft Raptor.
Wait, zombie we Christy. Have, we have
yo,
authentication
yo.
Keys and everything.
Yeah, hey. Yes.
Wow. I'm in.
You also have authentication keys. and they're
God, there. Bryce, you're just producing the shit out of the show.
This is all T2, and he set it up 20 minutes ago.
T2, you're doing Bryce's job. Yeah. This is amazing.
You are a credit. Right.
I can't hear shit.
Oh, but Estonia at large.
Tom, did you say you can't hear us?
No, I said I can't hear shit because you guys are watching. Oh,
yeah. And Bry, you're gonna run the
play
the
trigger
bidding,
man.
Right?
Yeah, yeah. Feel free to usurp me. I'm worried.
No, don't. Hey, by the way, while we're all here, let's do something nice for one of the homies that couldn't make it. Mikey Newman has been under the weather and in the hospital for the last couple of days. What do you say we just all Just a get well Mikey face on Twitter. Let's just shower him with a little love.
I'm gonna give him XOXO.
Yeah, don't prod. Just send him a lot of unconditional love.
Yeah, no, literally only say get well.
Give him hugs and kisses. Everything's hugs and kisses.
Don't prod. Yeah, whatever. Just be nice. Just pick him up.
Gosh, guys, be nice for once.
Yeah,
please.
Jesus, what for crying out loud?
So
why are you so mean always?
Sorry, say again.
Who's on what teams?
Good question. I actually have a graphic that is almost completely ready. So the teams are pretty – oh, that's right. I need to get the Frogpants, guys. We have Tom and Jenny on DTNS, Team DTNS. Brian and Justin are on Team Night Attack. Scott Johnson and Brian Ibbett will be Team Frogpants. Cargo, you and your the partner that you have will be on Team Massaworm. Father Robert Valser will be on Team Padre, and we might have Pete Delahanty with him if we can get him on Skype.
Oh, dude, that'll be great!
And then
we'll
Christine
finally have
Malongo,
Twit on back on the draft. On the draft.
Our team. Yay, cool. So it's dance with Hubrania. For right now.
Dance with Hubrania.
Oh, you know what? I have to do this now. I was gonna keep it quiet, but somebody literally just called it out in chat room.
Well,
Scotch Boy should join me. Hello, Mr.
God Bushwick. Damn it, you fucking Judas! What is this? God damn it! All right. What's the name of your team? Is it Independent Author Extravaganza? Although that's half of us here, huh?
I'm good with Massaworm.
Team Massaworm, all right.
We're Team Scotch Boys.
Scotch Boys!
Hey. Scotch Boys! Oh,
they got it,
all
there
right,
you
I'm
go.
Down for that.
Cheers, gentlemen.
Oh, here. what a good surprise! Oh, I'm so glad this is gonna.
Oh,
be great.
You don't even know. You have no idea. You will rue the. Oh, we're not doing that episode anymore.
Oh my god.
Oh, hold on, you
Tyler,
guys.
Can you hear me?
It's all gonna be fun and games until Cardinal says that life is the biggest movie of the summer.
Yeah.
All right, we have T2.
I kept conflating life and aliens.
Covenant.
Yeah. Covenant in my brain.
Watch the trailers, man.
I know.
I mean, like you could edit those two movies.
Amen.
Into each other.
Amen. You certainly could.
Yeah. Good. Brian and Scott, can you hear us?
Yes, yeah. We can.
Oh,
totally.
Fantastic.
Can hear.
Oh my God, Scott, are you having to do the XSplit workaround in Skype?
No, I just had to switch it. I'm good.
Oh,
I'm cool. Back. I'm here.
Hey, there okay. He is.
Good thing you finally looked at your graphic and realized, oh, yeah, Scott and Brian are playing this, too.
Okay, I'm sorry. Look, I'm trying to call 8 people, none of whom are my friends on Skype here.
Yeah, none of whom are his friends. He doesn't like any of them.
Yeah. You didn't score any points with me just now, either.
Oh.
It's all good.
Oh.
All right, so what's everybody's strategy?
Yeah.
Well, I heard Ryan's earlier on the stream.
That's right. Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
It was whoopsie doodle.
The pre-show is off limits to all competitors.
what'd you spill the beans on? What are we?
Oh no. I was just saying that we spent 90 minutes going through the movies because there's two layers to everything. First, you have to figure out what you think all the movies are going to be worth, what you think they're going to do. Then you have to reevaluate everything through the lens of like, what mistakes are all the other players going to make, and what is everybody going to overvalue?
Yeah. Christy Cates and I spent like 3 hours on Sunday trying to figure this out.
Yeah. Awesome.
Jenny and I are going to work it out right now.
Jenny and I are good. We're going to get Rogue One, and we're done.
Wait, no, it's not in any of the DTNS.
The general channel on DTNS. Why? Why do you ask?
Are you
I just built a time machine and guys, traveled back to 2010 and asked me myself then what I thought would do well. So trust that guy.
So, Cargill starts immediately shouting like, Green Lantern, Green Lantern, I want Green Lantern.
Well, Todd Cochran and I figured out a way to hack the voting or the bidding system. Uh-oh. So yeah, I've got that totally in the bag.
That's great. A trick since you haven't logged in.
Oh, shit. I have not used this system. This is going to be kind of crazy pants.
Oh, I thought I did log in.
Oh, are you guys actually
Make
doing
sure
your
you
bidding,
sign into Draft Raptor while we get everybody in.
No, like, they've got, like, man, there's. This has got to be some serious shit.
Okay, crazy.
We're in the second.
Can people watch what the bidding as live?
Yeah,
live?
Yeah, yeah. We'll monitor it live. We'll watch it as it happens.
I'm loving this. This is great. This is like big. It's like the real deal, guys.
Huge deal. Yeah, look at this. Awesome. That's all the different players and the values and all that stuff.
I think we all need to be shrouded in shadow and just have little cards.
This is you guys do the
bingo cards that we're holding up.
Exactly. With a picture of Brian.
This is like the precursor.
Hey, by the way, can I?
Go ahead.
Yeah, sorry, just off topic because you mentioned it. So I saw Get Out. Can I share one little thing? It's not about Get Out. It's more about the coverage of Get Out.
Sure.
That like. So I read all these articles like, the hidden like Easter eggs that you might have missed during Get Out. And one of them was like during the middle of the movie, there is a bingo game that is evocative of a slave auction.
Oh, my God.
And it's like. That was a slave auction. Like,
that was in the trailer.
It was a literal slave auction.
But it's also evocative. It is a slave auction, but it's also evocative of a slave auction.
I bet you figured out that it's a slave auction.
Evocative of somebody dying.
Padre, can you hear us?
I'll fix it. Hold on.
Padre.
I think he's working on it.
Oh, I'm so excited. The return of Team Twit.
Padre's got a blue halo. Look at that.
He looks great.
Is the illuminated copy of Padre that we have available.
That's awesome.
Yeah, you see why I went with this. This mm-hmm. is yeah.
No, carry on.
We're just discussing scotch.
What kind of scotch are y'all drinking?
We are drinking
whatever they got.
It is a Boonahabin 25. It is a small batch found by Lanark, bottled. It was distilled in 1989. And is a fantastic, powerful sipping scotch.
That's the worst audio ever. That sounds delicious.
What's going on? Patrick? Did you bring enough for everyone?
I did, but you guys didn't bring glasses.
Damn it.
Damn it.
I can empty the Seasiders can.
Oh, there we go.
Would it be accurate to say you're a troubadour?
There we go.
I think a troubadour would work.
One auctioneer.
Testing, 1, 2.
Hey, 3, there 4. We go.
Can you hear us? Could I bid 100 on chips?
Yeah. Woo! Yes, you can.
Good.
You probably just have
that's yeah. That's the sleeper. That's the sleeper hit entire century. Chips.
All right, guys.
Put all
is
your chips
place
on
where
chips.
We bid up yet, or is it Disney? Not? Does it not show till we actually start doing stuff? I don't have a box to bid in.
You should be able to log in, but I don't think any bidding has begun yet.
Yeah,
no,
you
I mean,
test
bid
yet. I'm interested in that test movie that you list.
Is it after the show? Yeah,
it's example show the movie it's based on.
Oh, here we go.
Oh, here we go. Bidding starting. You guys, hold on to your nuts.
So T2.
No, okay,
is running some tests.
Nothing's happening. These are bidding. I'm bidding 3. Damn it, 88. Come on. Why would you do that?
I don't need to get the first song queued up.
Stealing all the goddamn songs.
The funny thing about Satire Panic is it still makes me really panic.
Oh shit, Brian! Bid for 1%.
Oh shit! Yeah, all right.
What?
Dang it! There.
Bid is too small.
We've got this one, Scott. We got it.
Yeah, we totally got it. We're not gonna ever lose again.
You got 99.
I can't bid 100%.
Bidding has ended.
Oh, yeah, boo.
Yeah,
I guess that makes sense. That would be $0.
Yeah,
I don't like it. I'm against it.
Uh oh. Oh shit, wait, never mind. Oh shit, it's on. It's on. Test movie's back. Freed from its cage.
Oh, nailed it.
Coming this summer. 20%. Test movie.
Fuck you.
I like the chat room.
Ten! What? That's crazy. It's not worth that.
Oh, so it's actually the percentage of what people are actually
Wow.
Well, so that was the solution that we came up with. Like, what happens when somebody wants to spend more than all of their money on one thing?
Yeah.
They can accept a reduced portion of the money that it makes.
Oh, that's awesome.
I was not told there would be math. No math.
Mike, math people math. Are asking if you have a test movie song, because you're gonna serenade us through this draft. Oh, do you have a song for test movie?
Oh, test movie song. Oh, yeah.
This is the test movie. This is the greatest of all test movies.
Pretty good.
Yeah. There you go. That's
nice.
I'm four beers in. There you go. That's
Speaking of which, I'm gonna go get more beers.
Oh my god!
Are you guys not seeing my my video?
No, we're not. I see your logo. That's it.
We're not.
Because I see my video along the bottom.
Yes, I know.
Maybe if you start and
you're working
your video.
On it. Okay.
Hey, Padre.
Yo.
The way your head is positioned with that blue Twitch. Or Twit logo behind you. It looks like a halo, dude. That is so cool. And Delahanty's like your little angel man. He's keeping track of stuff.
Little angel man.
I'm a lot taller than Patrick.
I've seen Patrick in person. He's pretty tall. You must be a monster.
Did somebody say that?
Yeah. It's Cody's partner, Murphy. You know us too well.
I guess it's a little predictable.
I think we have space for just about everybody.
That's awesome. That's Bryce. That's
we don't
amazing, dude.
Yeah. Wait, we're missing. Oh, we're missing Scott. Yeah, we're
should
missing.
Should see
Scott.
Me. You see me?
No, we do see you. I mean, on this layout. So, what do y'all think? Like, what? Like 50 for Boss Baby?
Yeah, at least. I mean, it's a kids' movie. It's got Martin Sheen in it.
Martin Sheen.
It's all about
Martin
the Dark
Sheen?
Tower.
No. I think you mean Martin Short. And that's always a...
He looks like such garbage.
I was ready to spend everything on Rock That Body, and then the name got changed to Rough Night. I'm out.
That's ridiculous.
Oh, they changed the name? I was wondering.
Who does not want to pay money to see a Scarlett Johansson movie called Rock That Body? Let's be honest.
Fair point. It's a fair point.
Money.
You have to plus the rating on it though for me. That's like...
And Kate McKinnon to round out the appeal.
You need to see penetration. Like that's.
Oh no. Yeah.
I chased off the Padre.
That joke fell flat.
I know you chased him off. He was too scandalized by your wicked ways.
Something about penetration. It always does it.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Fucking screenwriters, man. Jesus. We have a whole bottle here.
Scotch. Dude, I love, hashtag Scotch Boys right now. You guys are already an early favorite here in the chat room. People are loving... Scotchboyz.
Maybe not B-O-I.
No, I was thinking B-O-I. Oh, yes,
with the B-O-I. Right. It's got to be with the B-O-I.
Fucking own it, man.
Or I won't.
All right. I'm in.
I'm down with the girls. And believe me, hey, guys, you remember the scotch I brought for last time I was on Night Attack.
Man, it was in and out so fast. It was like a blur. But I remember you brought scotch.
No, this it was great. Better. It was great scotch. I am not a Scotchman, but holy shit, I was.
That's
that
offensive.
I did find out that we talked about this on Modern Rogue, but I found out that I'm brothers with Murphy. I found out that I'm Irish.
Yeah, like almost as much as I am.
Yeah.
Which is, I mean, as someone noted in the comments of a recent episode, Murphy's head is too big for his body. Well, Irish, so come on.
Now, I'm seeing that we are missing Justin and Jenny from their teams on Draft Raptor, unless you guys
really?
Have decided.
Yeah, you should log in, because there'll be some moment, Justin, where you'll want to punch me.
Is it my... I'm going to ask a bunch of dumb questions. Hold on.
You can.
I bet there's an answer to this.
Okay, you can use any name you want, and you just use the authorization key that was in the email that I sent you guys.
I got it.
Padre, we've got you, but I don't see you in there, Delahanty.
This is a great layout.
No, Padre's going to be doing the bidding. Yeah, I'm just advising, and I've got the calculations.
Gotcha.
Here's our strategy.
He's the brains. Oh, okay. I'm just the eye candy.
And I missed that. Can you put that up again?
And Murphy, Cargill going to vote? Be bidding for you guys?
Yeah.
Okay.
Well, we'll be bidding together. We've had discussions, and one of us will do the typing.
Yeah, yeah.
Great.
My off code is not working.
Never mind.
I fucked up.
Can you hear us?
Yes, we can. Can you hear us, Padre? No, now we cannot hear you. you're testing the mute button.
That's our strategy button when we need to strategize. Get strategy.
More strategy button.
More strategy.
So we get right. Our strategy isn't strong enough. We got to make this work.
Bri, make sure you got your phone next to you.
Oh gosh.
Ooh, this son. Is not.
All right.
Oh, yeah,
wow.
That's right. That's
we're
right.
Talking it's back right. Channel it's negotiation.
Right. Know, that's, all right. Is that allowed? Is that legal? Is that still within the rules?
Here's the story.
Rippy dippy doo.
I can't hear shit.
Who can't? Man.
Let's get to Tom, who's on the scene.
Here, you get to mute it.
I can't hear shit.
Oh, right. The bit that we just did like 2 minutes ago. I'm like, why did that?
Sorry to keep scaring you, Bryce.
So Elix, I think it was Bobcat was also mentioning.
Brian, I sent you a test question, so just answer that for me, just so I know that the back channel is working.
Yes, everything on Captain Underpants.
Oh man, that's.
No, I don't think that the ability to smile or not smile is what would cause a slab of pork to become sexually attractive to a dog, Justin.
All right.
Really?
Okay.
Really? Come on, man.
Is that
a good strategy?
Maisie Williams?
I mean, if you ignore science.
Film?
Wrong. Yeah, that's, you know.
I mean, listen, man, I'm just trying to test experience. Why? And.
Okay, so we've got this, then.
Yeah, but you
it's
don't have
fair.
To take your clothes
I'm Catholic.
Off. To have
I'm
a good
not allowed
time.
To use the back channel.
Yeah, let's not make this blue, okay?
We just have to apologize for it later. It helps. Jesus likes it if you feel really bad about it.
Got it.
I saw the trailer for Girls Trip when I saw Get Out this weekend. There's a joke about a booty hole. The lady says
there
booty
is.
Hole bunch.
There
I laughed.
Is.
Booty hole.
I noticed there was
the
a lot of
bump,
ass-eating jokes in the Red Band Chips trailer. So
there's a lot of, did we just fuck? Like, LOL, like, and they make a gross face, and then there's a guitar riff. Like, there's a lot of those kind of jokes.
I smell money. That's not money. That's box office, my friend.
Yeah.
Run a Trips website for 22 years, and you don't get invited to the premiere.
No.
What? Oops. That's real. That's real talk, man. That's real beef. What the fuck? How do you not get invited to the premiere?
Wait, did you really run a Chips website?
Yeah, it's still running. It started in 1995.
Holy shit, I love the internet.
Was it on GeoCities?
Did you also set up Eric Estrada's website? Because that thing was golden in the golden age of the internet. I was pretty sure that Eric Estrada ran that website.
It was his sister, Erica Strada.
Erica Strada. Different last name.
Yeah.
Sister-in-law.
It's Ari Estrada. He's from L.A.
Oh, Tom, we talked to Patrick that time we did an autopilot for Chips. You remember that?
I do.
Yeah.
That was years ago.
Yeah, and that site was like our reference point for half the info we knew.
Yeah.
7mary3.geocities.com.
I have my
was
own
it the Soho path?
We are old internet users, all of us.
7mary3.
Scott, on a scale of 1 to yes, how amazing is Nerdtacular going to be this year?
one to yes. Trying to figure out what's in between those two.
two.
I'll say if yes is maximum, I'll say yes. It's going to be great. Are you kidding me? It's going to be amazing.
Awesome.
Are we invited?
Of course you're invited. It's already, that's an assumed thing. I probably should have made it more formal.
I probably should have actually invited you now that I think about it.
You should just email me. I'll just get all of it done.
Heck yeah.
All right. Oh, man.
It's going to be great.
Mm-hmm. By the way, tickets, unless you know somebody or you commit some kind of robbery like that, they're gone as gone can get, right?
Yeah, they were gone day. It took a day, and then we were out. Wow.
So. I mean, between you, me, and the wall, it seems like it's a free country. And if you wanted to get a room at the Snowbird Resorts, it seems like they'd probably reserve you one.
Probably, or if you, like you said, if you knew some sneaky trickery back channel stuff, you might be able to get it.
If only you were like watching a panel of 12 people, each of whom could probably get you into the events.
Yeah.
Wait, what is this?
By the way, I don't know what it is, but I want in.
Sounds awesome. Yeah. Back channels. And
all right.
Hey, look
on
at that.
On a completely unrelated note, Jenny, are there any other TV shows that you guys worked on that I could write a bunch of trivia questions about?
Yeah.
Oh, you mother
right
effer.
Here. He's ready to go.
Son of a bitch.
Dude, that's you're poking the bear on that one, man. Justin's about to Hulk out.
Do you want to do trivia about 7 one-season shows in a row? Would that be useful to you?
Perfect. Oh,
yeah,
perfect.
This time, hey, everybody, here's 15 questions on Kai Rizdahl's lunch.
Eggs. All the answers are eggs.
Hey, Justin, can you boost yourself up? And Jenny, you're a little
bit. Yeah, I can.
You're a little bit hotter than usual.
Well, okay.
Like you're always hot.
That is unlikely, Brian. That's very kind.
All right.
Everybody was just screaming, so I don't know if that's. Okay.
Here's all I'm saying. I got fucked so bad in the last trivia contest that they had to cancel it for a year. That was what Scott told me, is that the stink on this is so bad that we have to cancel it for a year and let it blow over.
It was positively Cargillian in its stink.
Cargillian. Yeah.
We had to let it simmer. We had to let it ferment after that.
How's that level?
That's good. That's a little too quiet, actually.
A little too quiet.
I performed so badly I was banished for half a decade.
That's true.
That's a little different.
You performed so badly that we told you on your way out, like, the only way you'll get on the show again is if you write a major Marvel Cinematic masterpiece.
All right. Can you say something for me, Jenny?
Masterpiece?
Yes. Hello. My name is Jenny. I work for the public radio show Marketplace, except for right now.
Great.
Hi, Jenny.
News of Jenny Josephson. They're not representative of American Public Radio.
Fuck yeah.
Cargo, can you, is there any way you can boost your audio or maybe move your mic a little closer to you guys?
The mic is actually running off of the camera, so let me see if I can boost my mic a bit. I probably can.
You know, that might actually be okay.
It's underwritten through a grant from Ralston Purina.
We're dealing with a lot of voodoo here, so we're only doing what we can.
As always, everybody, please remember to give thanks to not only God. Bryce, but also T2T2 for putting together Draft Raptor. It is the glue which binds this insane exercise.
Oh, you know what? As long as you're throwing out thanks, let's hear it for Sergeant Muffin, who is the backbone of DCTV.
Let's hear it from Mike TV, who's going to be crafting original songs and singing them throughout the draft.
Hey, let's hear it for Hollywood, who bothered to make these movies that we're betting on.
Thank you, Hollywood.
There we go.
God,
let's hear an apology for how I was treated during the trivia contest.
Yeah, it's showing my video along the bottom of Skype. It's just not showing in that little window. It's really weird.
I would say it's not the worst thing.
No, that's
true. You do look sufficiently majestic in this picture.
That's actually the way I'm posed right now, and my backdrop is indeed radiating stripes. So
perfect.
It works.
How's the audio now, out of curiosity?
That sounds good.
Out of everyone on the panel, you two will probably have to belt out the loudest to be heard, but I think...
Because that's going to be a fucking problem.
I don't know that we're any good at that.
I think we're terrible at that. I don't think this is our normal volume at all.
Team shrinking violets over there.
It's gonna get louder.
It's we still have a long way to go tonight.
Oh, that's volume juice, is it?
Volume juice.
Oh yes. Oh yes.
We will also get more handsome and funny.
As we go.
Hooray!
The more you drink.
The more you drink.
The seventh or eighth year we've done this, Justin.
Jeez. Holy shit. Now we're just getting into this really. What's depressing about how long we've done this is that we're getting into 10-year territory.
Yeah. And
on all these dumb fucking gimmicks.
I did not tell you, most of the folks on the panel, I've told a couple, but when I went to see Logan, I asked casually at the Alamo Drafthouse, I was like, hey, so how's Logan doing? Is it staying pretty full or whatever? And the chick got giddy. She's like, oh, it's been really full, which is great because we do this thing. It's kind of like fantasy sports, only it's a fantasy movie draft. And I was just like,
that's awesome.
Let me explain it to you. You guys have been doing this since
at least 2009, right?
Yeah, I think that is right. Because
yeah, when exactly yeah. I was on, I was still a film critic both times that I was on, and I haven't been on since I left being a film critic.
Yeah, it was before NSFW. It was BB Live Show territory. Mm. Wow. So yeah, that would have been summer 2009, which means this is our eighth annual. Wow. So great.
Awesome.
Crazy.
Do we have some kind of big bash for the 10th? A special edition?
We'll fly everybody out Letterman. Live.
Hey, by the way, that's not even a joke. Like, one of the things I'm thinking of doing is talking to the folks at the Draft House and say, you know, basically, I mean, obviously the idea has kind of sprouted, but we can lay claim to being one of the first. And I say one of the first because fucking Simpsons did it. But we could do it as a live event at an Alamo Draft House or something.
Oh, yeah. Hell yeah.
Yeah, that'd be cool.
Yeah, that's super hard to email Tim and get that going. That's really a hard, hard thing to do.
Yeah, well, I mean, it's not like I know.
Oh, shit. Austin who... Bigwig insults. That's right. Yeah, anyway, we're all connected to Tim League from the Draft House. Like, come on, fucko.
He's been running a business here for 18 years. How have you not interacted with him?
I did interact with him.
That's what I'm saying. I wasn't actually.
Where did you interact with Tim Lee?
Doesn't matter. It was a press
conference. Brian, where did you interact with Tim Lee?
I don't know. I posted an Instagram of us hugging or some shit.
Where were you?
I don't remember.
In space.
Brian, show me on a sponsored bar tour where you interacted.
A sponsored bar tour in a limo.
Yeah.
Don't show him. You'll go to hell.
Yeah. All right. That's fair. That's fair enough.
Yeah. Don't show Padre. Jeez.
Oh my.
Just try to find the places you're allowed to be touched.
That's right.
Fortunately, Brian does have the same anatomy as a stuffed bear.
Oh, got
it. That's accurate.
Oh.
Two glass eyes.
Those are the things that are the same. Two glass eyes.
Bryce, I know this is kind of a last minute curveball to throw you, but is it possible to just add like four or five more calls in here? Can we possibly?
We already literally just 12 calls right now.
I just worry that there's not enough people on screen right now.
Can we almost tell there are people in there still?
In the center by chance?
Yes. You
everybody more, tweet out what's happening right now. This is amazing.
You need more green.
We need more green people.
Who is the guy from like Soap and like
Billy Crystal?
Billy Crystal.
Yeah, Billy
Crystal. No, it was the other and wasn't he on like Roberto like Company? Jim Varney. This joke was funny in 1981.
Jim Jones. He murdered the people in French Guiana.
Mr. Jones and me by the Counting Crows.
Mr. Jones and me are going to be big stars.
Guys, I think we got it.
Oh, shit. All right. Oh, shit. Oh, shit. Oh, shit.
Yeah. I think we got it.
Let's do this.
Brian Ibbett hasn't been...
doing much for a while now.
Except for flexing like a boss. Yeah. Okay. Flexing and contemplating, that's how he does.
I was like, I'll already drink way more than you. No, no, okay. No. There may have been more than one refill already.
Okay, good.
Like, I mean, okay.
How it is.
Okay. I don't want to get all maudlin before we even start, but it will be an honor to lose to any one of these teams. I am so happy. I'm so happy. What?
Great effort, everybody. You're all great competitors.
Okay.
Brian's already trying to be humble about his victory before the draft starts.
Oh, by the way, don't think that Justin pointed out that if Night Attack wins, that'll mark 2 years straight of dynasty.
No. You'll put yourself in position for 2 years.
Oh, well, never mind. That's not nearly as impressive.
Yeah, but just
think, impressed by it.
Last place. I will have broken a streak, a record that no one will ever touch.
It's bigger than the Cubs winning the World Series.
All right, guys.
All right, ready.
This is, I just found out that this is our cold open.
Oh, my God, this is great.
So, here we go.